Revelation 16 and 15, that it said that he comes as a thief. That when people least expect, and he said, so as it was in the days of Noah, so will it be in that day, that the alarm is being sounded, but people are what? Not paying attention to the alarm that's being sounded, for the time is at hand. We have no time to waste. No time to waste. You see, when he was looking in this text, time does not mean the word chronos, which from which we get the Greek word chronos. It doesn't mean like a chronology, which we have today, like a time on a clock or calendar, because Jesus does not operate on a calendar. All right. For 1 year is like 1,000 in his sight. So if one, you know, is like 1,000, we're 2,000. So we cannot say because he hasn't come yet, he will not, for the time is at hand. My brothers and sisters, we don't have any time to waste. We don't have any time to be about the will of anything else except for what? The will of our Heavenly Father. For the Lord is coming, and he's coming. He's coming soon. See how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth, waiting to receive it until the early and latter rain. You see, we got to be patient. We got to have our hearts established, for the coming of the Lord is at hand. Yeah, the coming of the Lord is at hand. He said you can look and see all of these signs, and yet people still don't want to heed to the signs. You look and you see that there are wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes and divers places you never would have thought. In fact, even here in Arkansas, we're on that New Madrid fault line. It's there, a big one is prone to happen, and the earth is shaking not too far from here. All of these things that we see, that mother against father, father against son, and all of these things, he said the love of many again will wax cold. All of these things, he said all of these signs that we shall see, and yet we go about our lives living, trying to live them without God, as if that we have all the time in the world. That people say, oh, I'm young, I got time to work on this, I got time to do this. No, no time to waste, because what? You don't know when your time of departure is at hand. You don't know when your last moment, your last breath began upon this earth. You don't know when the Lord again to come, because he said he's going to come like a thief. And that means he's going to catch some people off guard. A lot of times people say, I'm going to lay my religion down. That moment you lay it down may be the time when the Lord comes. And you don't have time to pick it up. Because he said, whatever you're doing when he comes, just keep on doing it. It ain't no time there to be trying to say, oh Lord, I want you to do, save me, Lord, right now. He's going to say, you had every opportunity. He said, you remember on that September the 15th, when I had my servant Montgomery to proclaim that there is no time to waste, and yet you did not come. He said, not only the readers, but the hearers and the doers of his word. Time is winding up. In the land. Just think about it for a moment. And I don't talk much of current views, but just think about it for a moment. Just think about it for a moment. Look over there at the situation in Syria. They said this man has all these chemical weapons. The U.S. put ships over there. Warships. Russia also sent some warships. Everybody in the world got chemical weapons. The scripture says about the wars and the rumors of the wars and all of these things, tribulation and all of these things that are happening. Just look at it. Always on the brink of war. Before we can get through with one, there's another. That's what I say, my brothers and sisters, that we have no time to waste. And the man says, if we do attack him, guess what? He said that he's going to unleash war against the United States. And there are what? There are people again in this world that hate going to be a lot of people who say, well, if anybody make it, Lord, surely I will. But they're going to find out that surely I won't. Well, you got to be about our Father's business. Not only hearers, not only readers, but he said doers of his word. For I even know he said that there's going to be a lot of tribulation. But he says he's our faithful unto death. And I will give you a crown of life. You see, Jesus at the age of 12, when they were looking for him, they were in Jerusalem with his parents for the Passover. And instead of going back to Nazareth with his parents, he stayed behind talking with the teachers and the leaders in the temple. And when they found him, he responded to their question. They said, do you know why are you seeking me? Jesus said, don't you know I got to be about my Father's business? My brothers and sisters, the question remains for us today. Are you about our Father's business? Are you about your Father's business? Are you doing the work the Lord has called you to do? Are you busy trying to do everything that you can to spread the good news? Are you trying to spread the news that one day the Lord is sure to come? You see, that's all the message that I have. That's what the whole gospel is about. One day, the Lord is sure to come. And I know when I read in his word, he said that it is his will that everybody should be saved. But not everybody is going to be saved. But I have you to know, if there's anybody that want to be saved, God has already laid out the plan of salvation. For he said, if any man would confess with their mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in that heart, he said, thou shalt be saved. But I want you to know, we don't have any time to waste today. For the time is at hand. And we need to be about our Father's business. We need to go out and tell somebody that the Lord is on his way back. We need to go out and sound the alarm that if you are not already on the Lord's side, way it is, and untrue. For all we know is what we know now. At this present moment. We don't know about the next. Time is not. I tell you what the will of Jesus is. And he said in his word, if we can believe in our heart and confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus, he said we shall be saved. And he said there's a blessing to the readers and hearers of his word. We got to make sure that we listen and pay attention to the reading of God's word. For when heaven and earth pass, God's word is going to stand forever. And then he says we got to become doers of his word. And he has promised us a blessing if we do that. Even during the tribulation that shall come upon the earth, he said in Revelation 2 and 10, he said, be thou faithful. That's what God looks for, faith. He says, be thou faithful until death, and I will give you a crown of life. But we have no time to waste. We got to go and tell everybody the Lord is on his way back. We got to go and share the word with them that if you need, you need to come now before it's too late. And we don't know when that too late moment is. But we don't have any time to waste to be about our Father. And those are the church that offers. We don't have any time to waste. Life is too short to waste. And all of these things, if we spend all of our time on things that don't matter. There are some important things in life. Knowing the business of our Father, which are in heaven. Money is good, but money ain't all. Jobs are good, but they won't get us into heaven. Prosperity, the pleasures of this life, the lust of this flesh, they won't do nothing for us. The only thing that we have that will stand is Jesus. And standing on his word, that we ought to just tell everybody. Now is the time to get saved and stay saved. But we have no time to waste. To stay prayed up. To stay watchful. To stay on the battlefield. No time to leave the ark of safety. But stay with the Lord. For if you stay with the Lord will certainly stay with you. If you're here today, we ask you to come while the blood still runs warm in your mind.